Anybody, John Hopkins, Washington Jefferson update?
Time is 28:30.
How much time? No, they're not even overtime yet.
9 minutes.
A lot of game.
You guys play Hopkins?
Which, 95% of our alumni, we do not, and played one time in school history. In the last 60 years, they played once, and it was postseason. They won 24-17. But 95% of our alumni base lives within an hour of Baltimore. They don't have enough. If they see 10,000 people, then they know for all the people that'll show up. And then last time, y'all won't trip you, I just sit talking around my mouth all day. The 1993 team, the last Frostburg team to make the playoffs, Washington Jefferson beat them in the second round. Beat them handily. And then Washington Jefferson ended up losing the national title that year.
All right, ready to get started, Coach?
As soon as you are.
All right, we're here with Coach Fitzgerald after the first round win over Wittenberg here in Springfield. I'll just open up the floor to Coach Fitzgerald on his comments.
What do y'all want my comments to be? Somebody asked me something.
Who called that fake punt? What did you guys see?
It was a combination. My idea originally, but then I run it through the special teams coordinator and make sure he's okay with it. Here's the ballsy part for myself and the special teams coordinator is we run it 2 weeks ago and got stuffed. So we had shown it on film. But the last time we punted, we knew that we were only going to have to block one person to get the edge, and we thought Dante would read it right. And anyway, and good call. Lucky call.
3 yards allowed rushing in the first half, 45 overall. You know, you and I talked about it several times this year. You've helped three teams to negative rushing yardage in a game. Is it as much as you were up early, or do you think the defense just really keyed in on the run?
Their game plan wasn't to run the football on us. We didn't know when we came out on the field today that number two was hurt, that their tailback was hurt. I don't know if they scrapped the game, if they scrapped their run game because of him or if it was something else, but their plan wasn't to run the football on us today. It was to throw it, and I could look here and where am I at? Young man, 34 attempts. So they threw the ball 36 times today, which is a lot when you think the wind's blowing 22 miles an hour in one direction. Now, on that note, we are great at run defense. If you don't double-team Niles, he's going to make the play. So you have to put two people or three people blocking our defensive tackle, and it allows everybody else to run and make plays. And not that we don't have other great players on defense, but what we do have is we've got 18, 20 unselfish guys that will run the football, tackle football.
Jamal, on that run, I was on the sideline for a little bit. Everybody kept saying, keep going, you're going to break one. Yeah. What did you think? Did you know it was just a matter of time, or were you not even thinking about that and just kind of taking time off the clock there in a second?
Honestly, I just was thinking about taking the time off, getting the first down, and the whole line just blocked it very well. I don't think I even had to mix anybody miss. I just hit it, and I was gone. And Coach been bothering me all year about busting a big one, so I'm happy I got that one.
You guys have been in playoff mode really since week 4 or 5 of the season. Does that help going into this game? It seemed like you guys always capitalized and made the big plays that needed to be made.
We don't look at life or at football like that. And you're the second or third person this week's talked about how long we've been in playoff mode. And whether it's the first game of the season or the 13th game of the season, which we hope to still be playing then, we're just going to play one game at a time. Our schedule is going to be the exact same during the week, as close as we can keep it to normal, and we're focused on whoever the next opponent is. Never, ever look forward. We didn't talk about the playoffs or making the postseason until D3.com put out the predictions on Thursday before the final game, Thursday of last week, and had us left out. And I could see some of our guys' shoulders had slumped. So then we had a quick team meeting to make sure the point for life and for the rest of their lives is let's go beat Salisbury this week and take care of only the things that we can take care of and let everybody else do their job.
Dante, you took the fake punt 93 yards all the way for the touchdown. How does it feel to have that fake punt work in a big playoff game like this?
It felt great because, 2 weeks ago we tried it against Keene and they got stuffed, mostly because of me. But they called it and I have the option, and Christian Poland, I just followed him, took me to the promised land, and the guy blocked downfield, felt great, first one.
And defensively, your success on third downs, you guys were really locked in. It really started on first down. You guys weren't letting them get into third and short situations. But just knowing that your offense was kind of in control, the pace of the game, how important was it for you guys to get the ball back to them as quickly as you could.
Right, that's what we kept telling every time we go out there. So we get the ball right back to you. It's coming right back to you. So we spot there, win for a second down, and third down, get off the field.
How much pride do you guys take as players being just the second Frostburg team ever to make it to the playoffs, second one ever win a game? And you know, what do you know about the history and tradition of the program that, you know?
We're not, and I'll answer, both of them can answer too. Y'all are free to speak, man. We're not in competition with that 93 playoff team. And let it be known, we're not here without them. Those 93 guys have been successful here, been successful here, and the head state trooper in the state of Maryland, and the guy that owns the biggest plumbing company in the state of Maryland, and the number one prison warden in the state of Texas. And I can go on and on about them, but they've been ultra successful. And every month we get a financial donation from them that in the state of Maryland right now, at our university right now, we wouldn't have money for the helmets, wouldn't have money to travel and feed our guys like we should. The alumni, and especially all the alumni, but that 93 team, we're not in competition with them, and they're our biggest fans. I'll bet you we had more players from the 93 team travel west to this game than any other graduating class. But they're all out there tailgating, and I saw some of them in the stands today. We're not here without them. On the history and tradition of the school, we just take it one week at a time. We are cognizant of the fact that we don't get a lot of respect week in and week out. We're also cognizant of the fact that we've had a football team for almost 60 years. We have a losing record. Now, won't be much longer. But overall, our record has been, since 1961, we're in a negative column.
Guys, did you play, you know, especially after the success you had last year and getting left out, did you guys play with a little chip, you know, all off season, take that into this season?
I'm gonna answer that for our team. Yeah, we took a little chip because last year we felt like we had a great team, and defensively last year we were great. And going into this off season, we hung our hat on defense, but offensively we took it on our shoulders. Like, you know what, we're gonna have to give the defense a break this year because, you know, we lost some key players, but our defense is still outstanding. But I think as the offseason, we, as a team, as an offense, we came in this year, like, you know, we had to put some points up this year. And maybe if we'd have put up more points last year, we'd have made it to the playoffs. But this year, we took it upon ourselves and said, you know what? We feel like we had probably the best OC in the NJAC and maybe one of the best in the conference, in the country. But we just took it upon ourselves and decided to play ball this year.
You talked about the snub, Adam, that the off-season workouts were particularly spirited.
And then getting here today and finally getting the opportunity, it seemed like you guys were just out there having fun, just being excited just to play, and not maybe some teams that have been there so many years have a little pressure. Did you feel that you guys were playing loose in some ways?
I think for us, one of our coaches, Coach Mary, always says, name the space of opponents. Doesn't matter who you're playing. You're playing yourself every week. So it's what you can give, but want to know each play. Doesn't matter who you're playing. Same every week.
Pressure's self-imposed. We like each other and like playing football. They may have a different take. I don't see a lot of pressure.
It's just motivation. I believe we're underdogs coming in here. This week we felt like we're a good team and we had to prove ourselves this year. No nervousness on our side of the ball or defense. I felt like we just went out there and played.
Caleb, best question of the day, Caleb, first off. Everybody over here to know that. Best question. Caleb, we thought we had the best defense in the Eastern United States, and still a year later, we're good on defense now. But we have All-American defensive end to go along with an NFL D tackle where you can only double one of them, and the other one's single and go make 10 tackles. But we thought we lost a great linebacker last year, had a safety that was a real player, and then he's now one of our GAs, but our three tech last year, a good football player, really, our nose guard, I should say, really, really good football player. We lost them. But anyway, to answer your question, We thought we had the best defense in the country last year, so yeah, we felt like we should have been in the playoffs. On the nervousness, I would say this: this is a family type atmosphere. Our accountability to each other is through the roof, day in and day out.
that everything? Great.
Gentlemen, thank y'all for having us.
Thanks, guys. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Thank you.